Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. On today's video, as you can see, I'm not wearing any makeup right now because we are going to be doing the YouTube trend that is going on right now, which is I followed blank makeup look, makeup tutorial video. So on today's video, I'm going to be doing Desi Perkins. I'm going to be playing the video somewhere right here, and we're going to be following each step she does. Of course, if I don't have a product that she's using, I'm going to switch it for something that I have similar. So we are going to be following step by step. But before we get started, please make sure you subscribe to my channel if you're not already. Also, at the end, give it a thumbs up if you like this video. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started.
Back to my channel. For today's video, we're going to be doing a makeup tutorial on this look right here, which is using the new Jaclyn Hill and Morphe palette. I just got around to playing with this the other day, and you guys loved the makeup look and wanted a tutorial. So here we are with a tutorial. These tones in particular from the palette, because I watched Jamie. Meet Jamie.
Hi guys.
I love her. I'll link her in the description box. She has the most incredible Scottish accent that just, she could say anything and I'm like, yes. I hope you guys like it.
Let's go ahead watching it on my phone.
First, before I start, I think I'm going to conceal my breakouts. They're healing though, so that's good. They're just a little bit red still. If you guys haven't checked out my last video, make sure you go check it out because I show you guys how to cover it. I'm so happy that they're, you know, healing. They're just red. They're mostly kind of flat, so I'm going to take my Becca concealer and just put a little bit on to start. Blending in with my
I don't have
brush,
a Becca, so I'm going to be using the Naked Skin.
So first, I'm taking a base. This is the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. I'm going to take the Sigma Precision Flat Angled Brush, and I actually dipped one drop of Duraline in here because it makes it nicer to work with, not as drying if your lids are drier. I love this eyeshadow base when I'm doing really intense looks.
So I don't have that MAC Paint Pot, but I'm just going to be using my concealer as a primer like she's doing. So let me just apply this real quick. And then she's blending it with a brush. So I'm just using my Morphe M173, which is what I use to buff my primer.
Blends out all the redness on my eyes, but I'm gonna put a very light layer of it. I'm so happy you guys liked my last video. It really meant a lot to me how supportive you guys all were. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
So the only thing that the palette doesn't really have is like a matte light shade to set your base.
True.
So I'm just picking up a matte bone colored shadow. It's gonna make it easier for us to blend all these colors.
A matte bone color.
We're actually gonna take an even lighter color and just put it on the brow bone up here.
Girl,
just
wait.
A white eyeshadow.
Okay. So yeah, that's true. Jaclyn doesn't have a matte shadow here. So, So she says something like a bone color. So I'm using this Morphe shadow and this in the shade Cream Puff. And it's just like a bone color. So I am going to be setting my eyelids with this.
Or something, just to give a little highlight up in this area. We're going to go into the Jaclyn Hill palette. Boom. So I'm taking it back 224. And I'm going to start with this orange shade over here. It's like a very nice tangerine color, and I'm gonna start applying this in the upper crease as a transition shade. So dipping back into that tangerine color.
Okay, so it's called Creamsicle, this tangerine color. So we are going to be using, I don't have that brush, I don't think so. So I'm just using a Morphe M505, which is also a fluffy brush. So she is putting it on the crease.
Lightly swishing that into the upper crease of the eye, and then whatever's left over on the brush, I bring it out back here just so there's a nice fade on the outer part of the eye. Next, I'm taking a mixture of this color right here and also this shade right over here, both matte shades. And
okay, let me just do my other eye because she's only showing one eye, so I'm just going to do this real quick. I think this looks lighter on me just because she is a little bit tanner than I am. So we just hope it looks kind of the same.
I'm still using my MAC 224 for that. And I'm going to place that right under where I've like.
Okay, so she's using Hans and Roxanne right here. So she's mixing both of them, and she says she's putting it under her crease, like where we put the shadow. So
it's that tangerine color. Same very light motions here. Okay. You blend up too far with this color that we're applying now, it's going to cover everything we did with that tangerine shade, and you're not going to have as good of a gradient. So make sure you try to stay right underneath it. Gives you that sunset look. Sometimes I will cover my transition shade on accident because I blend up too far.
I think I did that.
A clean brush and the transition shade again, and I'll buff out the edges just so it peeps through one more time. Kind of bringing it into the outer corner here. Circular motions. So I stopped using the MAC 224 for a while, but the other day I was like, oh man, you know, I'm going to pick that back up again because I used to use it all the time and I forgot how much I loved this brush. It's a little bit larger than like a MAC 216 or one of my Smith brushes, but it does really help you blend because it's so soft and fluffy. You just have to make sure that you stay in the right area, but it buffs out edges like really, really nicely. It's perfect for transition colors. So if I want to go back into the transition shade, I can, and really blend out those edges too, just to make sure that we don't lose any of the tangerine color.
Okay.
I'm going to take a smaller brush. This is the Smith 235 brush. This one has a really nice fine point, so it's going to get really into the crease, which is what we want.
Okay, so she is using the shade Jax. So
brand shade, and I'm using the Smith 235 for that. This brush has like such a nice fine point, but it also has a fluffy outer part of the point, so it's gonna get into the crease and also blend it for you. Look down into my mirror so I can really get into that crease, really buffing it in. And I start with a very, very small amount of product because when you work with darker colors, you can mess up a lot easier. So if you start with a little bit of product first, it's gonna be better for you if you do mess up.
Yes.
This color is super pigmented too, so I barely put any on. It's already pretty intense. That's it, that's all I'm not gonna do back in because we're gonna use one last shade. So I have my MAC 224 brush always next to me so that if I need to, I can buff out any edges afterwards. It's really good at diffusing colors, so I just use that to lightly go over all the eyeshadows that I put down. It's just gonna give it a nice soft look. I know this is a lot of colors, but then I went into this really, really deep espresso brown here. And this is where we're gonna deepen everything and really define it. The lowest part of the crease is where you want to place this.
Lowest part, so.
So if you notice, every time I dip into new eyeshadow product, I put it where I want the product to be most pigmented. Which is right into the crease, and then whatever's left over, I always lightly feather it out so that everything starts to like blend into the rest of the face, if you will. I'm going to take a clean blending brush with no product on it and smooth out the edges of everything one last time. Taking this old copper eyeshadow on a flat concealer brush, and I lightly dampened it with some Fix Plus. Doesn't need it, but I just feel like it.
Okay, so she grabbed that shade, so now we're gonna spray it with Fix Plus just like she said.
Makes it a little bit sharper so I can cut the crease a little better.
Oh, she's cutting the crease?
And I'm just going to round out the shape here on the crease. I went in with a very light amount first so I could get a good guideline. But now we got to build it up.
Okay, build it up.
It's very fiery. I love coppery eye looks, and I feel like they look so good on so many different eye colors. If you have hazel eyes or green eyes, or like really even light brown eyes, it just makes them pop so much.
I do have hazel eyes.
Look lighter. Yes. I'm gonna pick up my Smith 256 brush.
Okay, hold on. Because she only does one eye at a time. I mean, she's only doing one eye, so I need to do both of my eyes. So let me just do this one real quick.
I'm going to take this shade right here that we used in the crease. So we're just going to take that and place it right here. Feather it so it has a little bit of depth in that outer corner. Also, don't worry if you mess up over here because we can clean it up with concealer later. I'm going to take the deeper maroon shade and apply that at the very, very edge of the outer V here. We are making moves. Oh, I love these eyeshadows. Oh my god. My God. I just saw J-Lo on her Instagram live wearing the high key fades, and I about died. I know she's been, I mean, no, the silvers. She was wearing silvers, but she was wearing fades the other day, and I about died. I mean, she is, like, iconic, okay? I love her. She's worn almost all the colors. I've seen her wear gold, black, and fades, and the silvers. Let's apply our lashes since we're here. I'm using the Voluminous Lash Paradise Waterproof Mascara, and this is by L'Oreal. This one right here, it's really good, actually. For me, I have such little lashes, so it's one of those mascaras that really sticks to each individual lash, but doesn't clump up. Like, it adds a thickness around every lash without making it look super clumpy. My kind of formula. Also, update, I ran out of Latisse, and I have yet to go buy another bottle, so I haven't been using it for like the last 3 weeks. I need to go get more because my lashes are starting to like go back to normal. You could apply a black wing if you want with this look, but I did not. But if you guys want to do a wing, then do a wing. Alright, so I'm gonna be using the Meraki lash glue. Oh, I'm using Queen Bee lashes.
I don't have those lashes, and I don't have that glue.
I go back to the first lash and put another thin layer to make it extra sticky. Let them sit and dry for a second. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and apply the lashes now. Coming up from above. Yes.
She already applied her lashes, so I'm just going to be doing that real quick. And I do need to cut these lashes because they're a bit long. And she's also using the Queen Bees. I don't have those lashes, so I'm just using some wispy lashes to put on some lashes because I don't have any lashes on. I mean, I don't have any eyelashes. I think this video is going terribly wrong because I hadn't seen this video, so I wasn't prepared. But it's okay.
Mm-hmm. Typically, I would then move on to doing the rest of my face makeup.
So I apply my lashes now.
And then finish the eyes, but I'm filming by myself right now, so I'm just going to finish the eyes first. And then
me too, girl.
And do the rest of my face. So I got to put a little concealer on so that I could blend the eyeshadow out on my lower lash line.
Okay, I've never done that.
This is literally like my favorite. I've been using it all the time now. Luminous concealer, medium. This is the Morphe G37.
I never apply concealer before my foundation, but just because she's doing it, we're gonna do it. So again, I don't have that concealer, so I'm just using the Naked Skin, and this is in the shade medium light neutral. So she does apply her concealer first. She didn't even apply primer, so I never do that either. And she's buffing it with a brush, but I'm gonna use my beauty blender.
Very similar to the other one I used. I'm just gonna blend that in really quick. Right, so moving on to the lower lash line, I'm gonna be using the Marc Jacobs Cocoa eyeliner pencil. Apply that into the waterline and also on the lower lash line slightly. Do it messy because we're gonna blend it out with.
I don't have that eyeliner in Cocoa, but I do have the Sephora co-liner in the shade Cocoa, which I'm guessing it's kind of the same thing, but cheaper. So she did apply it under her waterline, and she said messy because we are going to be blending it. So
shadow. Okay. Over the lower lash line, I'm going to first start out with this shade over here and apply that with a Smith 253 brush. Always start at the outer part of the eye first with the most product and then work it inwards to the inner corner. And actually, I'm going to use a fluffier clean blending brush to diffuse that. It can look crazy really fast. I'm going to keep using this brush. This is the Smith 230. And I'm going to go into the tangerine shade and also buff that under the eye. Mostly on the outer part and connect it to the top. On a pencil brush, I'm going to use that on the very, very outer corner. That way everything that's deepened up on the outer corner here will also be deepened up on the outer corner of your under eye. If you need to take your blending brush, go back in and diffuse it a little bit, you can do that. And then you can go ahead and apply mascara to your lower lashes, which I'm going to do off camera because mine are very difficult to do and I'll just be covering it the whole time because they're very tiny, so I'll be right back.
Yes.
So now moving on to the face makeup, I'm doing a pretty...
Okay, hold on. I'm gonna apply my mascara to my bottom lashes. Mine are tiny too, but I'll just do it right here. I'm sorry if I'm not really talking. It's because I'm real concentrated on what she's doing, so I can follow exactly what she's doing. So she's moving on to the face.
Similar routine as my last video that I uploaded, using my Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk. I'm gonna try the color 8 today just to try to match my neck a little bit better. Taking that on a little dish, and I'm gonna mix it with my MAC Stroke Cream.
Okay, so I don't have that foundation. I don't have any luminous foundation, so I'm just going to be using this Maybelline one. And I do have a strobe cream, so I'm going to be adding some of that like she did. And as I could see, she did not apply any primer to her skin, so I'm just going to add a little bit of strobe cream.
Foundation, make it even more luminous, and just give it that really healthy look finish.
So she's applying her foundation with a brush. I never do that, but because she's doing it, we're gonna do it.
Good for me. Now take my beauty blender. I'm gonna blend all of that in. Okay, so now we have a nice sheer layer of foundation.
Ooh, she's done. Okay, hold on. I'm just blending this in because she doesn't even show where she's blending it, so she's already blended.
Brush, okay. And this is the Morphe G40, and I'm gonna go lightly over my problem areas just one more time with padding motions.
I don't have any acne, so I'm not going to go over with anything
so
more.
So since my breakouts are in the healing process and they're a little bit more flat, I'm not gonna do the Studio Fix trick that I showed you guys in my last video because there's no bumps. You can apply a light layer to just kind of conceal them a little bit more though if you want to. This stuff is just heavy duty. It's really going to conceal further. And in the last video I put a little bit more concealer over top, but I'm just going to leave them like that. I'm going to apply a little powder to my oilier areas. This is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder, just on the sides of my nose and on my forehead, in the center, and on the chin. I'm taking a fluffier brush and swirling into that.
Okay, so she did not use concealer under her eye anymore to highlight, so she's just setting her face mainly. So I'm just going to be, I don't have that powder, so I'm just using a translucent powder. And she's mainly putting it like around her nose and here.
Powder and just patting it over the breakouts too. I'm gonna pick up the MAC 116.
Okay, she's setting everything, so I'm just gonna set everything.
This is NC43, and I'm gonna apply it where I would apply my contour and just lightly tap into it to get a little more coverage in that area.
I don't need that, so I'm not gonna do that.
This is NC40 for the center of my forehead here, so that it's a little lighter, and it's gonna cover the breakouts there. So I didn't forget to apply my liquid glow before I put all my powders on my face.
Liquid glow?
I didn't put too much powder here, and not really that much here either, so It's fine. It's not a big deal. But if you're doing this at home, make sure you apply your liquids first, then your powders. And I'm using my mixture here. This is the Marc Jacobs Do You Drops with the Iconic London Original Shade Drop. By the way, this
I don't
is
have
like a
that.
Candle holder from Michael's Craft.
So I'm just using a highlighter.
It's just nice to.
And this is a ColourPop highlighter in the shade Strobe Glow.
The foundations. I think I'm a mad scientist sometimes. I'm like blending 5 different foundations just to see what happens.
I do that, yes.
So here comes the glow. Right down the center of the nose.
Okay.
The reason I mix these two highlights is because the Iconic London one is very, very powerful. And sometimes it can be too powerful for the more of like the wet look that I'm going for. Like it could look dark. I need it to be a little bit lighter. And then the Marc Jacobs one dilutes it a little bit. But I still get the intensity. It's just not as crazy.
Oh, girl, that's a lot of highlighter.
Someone told me that they don't like to do the chin highlight because it looks like chicken grease, like after they've eaten KFC. And I totally agree, but I still fucks with it. Look at that. Boom.
Boom.
I'm going to go ahead and do that to the cheekbones as well.
Okay.
I like to do the highlights first because now, because I did that darker powder, the highlight is like kind of going into it. Sometimes it can turn ashy, or it can, like, since it's a liquid product, it doesn't blend as seamlessly as it would if I was just blending it on top of a liquid. So it's really important to do all your creams and liquids first and then your powders.
Yes.
But I got so into it that I forgot. Also putting that on the forehead. Okay. Alright, liquid glow done. I'm gonna set the glow.
She is glowing.
Glow. I'm gonna be using the Dior Air Luminous in 001 with a Sephora fan brush. This has a little bit of like a rose gold undertone, so I think it might look really nice with the
rose gold. So this is rose gold. I'm not using that, but I'm using the Maybelline.
Dust that over all that liquid glow.
Oh wow. She's really going in.
Some would say it's impossible, but.
So we are gonna be so highlighted.
Foundation brush. So finishing off, I'm gonna apply a little bronzer. This is the Terracotta shade 05. This is the Guerlain.
I don't have that, so I'm just using a butter bronzer by Physicians Formula.
And my MAC 137 brush. This brush is so good for applying bronzer when you have breakouts.
I don't have that.
It's so soft. It like disperses the product without like moving anything around too much under the skin. So it's just a very soft brush, and I'm gonna in circular motions apply it to the hairline first over here, and then bring it down the hollows. Also along the perimeter of the forehead. We don't need to apply too much because we applied a little bit of a darker shade of our MAC Studio Fix. There's already a little depth there. Just kind of going over it lightly. Okay, so I decided to go with MAC Copper Tone Blush to stick with the coppery shades of this whole look. So it's all in synergy.
I don't have a copper tone, but I do have like a bronzy brownish tone, so I'm just gonna be applying that.
The final step is the lipstick combo that I used. The new Dose of Color Lip It Up sticks. These are so good. The formula is like really creamy, really pigmented, hydrating, and I mixed two colors yesterday. I used Brulee and Toast. I'm gonna go with Toast.
I don't have those shades, so I'm just gonna be using ColourPop like Luxe lipsticks and the shade Stone Fox and Uno Mas.
So Toast is pretty just like by itself. It's like a really nice nudie tone, but I wanted to make it a little bit more pink, so that's why I applied Brulee over top. It's like the perfect color with this eye look. I'm gonna set everything with a little spray. Fix Plus, my MAC.
MAC Fix Plus? Spray
everything? I'm actually just doing that because I'm hot. And that's it. This is the finished makeup look. I love this makeup look. I love the tones. I hope you guys like it. Don't forget to tweet me photos if you do recreate it. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Bye.
Ooh. I think, did I go into that color?
Oh, some little bloopers? Okay.
I forget what I did.
Okay, so another thing that I forgot, she did have her eyebrows on the whole video, so I'm just going to be doing that real quick and I'll be right back. So this is the final result. We finished the look and I followed every single step that she did. Obviously, stuff that she has I do not have, but yeah, I tried my best and I think it looks pretty close to her. My face does look a little bit greasy because of all the highlight that she used. So yeah, this is final result. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and thank you so much for watching, and until next time, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.